Hey, I'm Molly Morrissey. I grew up in Chattanooga and went to school here at Auburn and loved it so much I never left.
Hey, my name is Bo Morrissey. I work at Auburn High School and went to Auburn University as well and met Molly there. We've been married for the last 10 years and have been attending Cornerstone for the last 8 years.
After about 5 years of being married, we decided we want to start our family and, did not come easy for us. We tried for about a year with no luck, and Molly started some fertility medicine, and it still took us another 8 months, but the Lord blessed us with Blakely Jane, who is now turning 4 in January.
So we had Blakely in January of 2013, and it really was just picture perfect. She was a perfect baby. January of 2014, I was just over the moon because I found out that I was pregnant. And so I ran in and told Bo, and we were just thrilled. And a few days after I found out that I was pregnant, I found out that I was miscarrying. And that just was the shock of my life. Thought that, you know, we had struggled so hard to get pregnant with Blakely, and when I'd gotten pregnant relatively easy this go around, you know, that was it. I was just thinking in my head, like, okay, Lord, like, thank you for this testimony. We have this struggle and we have this miracle on Blakely, and now we're gonna just have all of our children and live happily ever after, and we've kind of dealt with our struggle. Through some dark days and a lot of crying and tears and questioning and praying. A couple months later, I ended up taking another positive pregnancy test. And so at that point, you know, here I go again. I'm like, okay, like, whoop, we had that hiccup earlier this year, but like, that was our struggle. Like, we worked through it, we're good. God, you're good again. Weeks later, I found out that I was miscarrying again, and I was personally just wrecked. Well, after 3 miscarriages, you go see a specialist, and I was like, well, I can't deal with 3 miscarriages. I'm not gonna do that. So we did the first round of IUI, and it didn't work. I'll blame a lot of it on the fertility shots. It was pretty intense, and I just was in a really terrible place, to be honest. I was really incredibly broken. I don't know how else to describe it other than I was just in a really dark place, just physically, emotionally, and spiritually. I was really pretty angry that we were having to walk this path. I did not want any part of it. I got out of bed and I went and got in bed with Blakely, who was at that point 2-ish, 2, and just crying and praying and holding her. And I just finally let God speak to me. And, you know, I just was like, just stop. Like, I was trying so desperately to control what I wanted our family to look like and what I thought it should look like. And I finally just was like, I've got to stop. I've got to take a break. We woke up the next morning and I told Bo, hey, you know, I got to take a break. And then a couple weeks later, I actually took a positive pregnancy test again. And while we were cautious, I thought in my head, like, yes, like, I surrendered to God. I can check that off the list. Like, that's what he was trying to teach me. I've learned my lesson. And we're good. We went to have an ultrasound and there was no heartbeat. Like, I refused to let myself go back to the place where I was earlier the past 2 years. And so I told Bo that I wanted to go see a counselor and just try to help sort through everything. And he was supportive and encouraging enough to Seek went out, and we actually got to go together, which was incredible. I think everybody should do that. We kind of came to terms at different times, but felt that our family was not complete and that all of these steps were leading us into a certain direction to grow our family, and we decided to start the adoption process.
So as a husband, I had to kind of figure out how in the world am I gonna help my wife and my family through this process. It had been just very, very stressful on both of us, and you know, our tanks were running on empty at that point, and the grief counseling was just a massive relief for that. And we just, through careful prayer and consideration and just wise counsel with family and friends who had been through that process already, we realized that the Lord was leading us to this point and that adoption was gonna be the right next step for our family. And it's a process we're still in right now, and we're very excited and we're terrified at the same time of what the future holds. The Lord has a master plan for us and what our family looks like in the future. And we are both just super excited to see where that leads us in the next year.